Hello, how are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. How about you?
Good, thank you.
You're welcome.
I also need a steering rack as well for a Ford Escort 1.6. Do you have the part number?
The part number for the power steering rack for a Ford Escort 1.6 is PR18539.
Welcome everyone. So in this step-by-step demo, we will show you how to build and create a voice-activated web page that allows real-time audio queries with a friendly GPT-powered chatbot as a digital agent. This solution, it uses Azure OpenAI with AI Foundry, AI Search, and a text-embedded model to retrieve knowledge from private PDF documents stored in Azure. So we have a frontend and a backend solution which is deployed from Microsoft GitHub code. So the frontend, it receives the audio input and it sends that to the Python backend, which interfaces with Azure OpenAI real-time API, and it includes a tool for searching Azure AI Search. Whether it's for 24/7 customer support or internal knowledge access, this system demonstrates how Azure AI tools come together for a seamless conversational experience. In this example, we have a PDF document of automotive car parts, which is uploaded and indexed by Azure AI Search to query the dataset from a voice-activated response. It can be used for a wide range of use cases for customer support to solve the lack of fast 24/7 round-the-clock support for customers. It could also be used for general FAQ questions that are repeatedly asked to free up staff to be used in other complex cases. Has many other benefits, such as always available. There's no need for human agents to cover every time zone. It's very scalable, handles thousands of queries simultaneously without downtime. It's consistent, it delivers uniform responses based upon the same knowledge set, and it can also handle different languages with ease. So yeah, the chatbot, it can talk to users freely to understand questions and give helpful answers back, being trained on a wide scope of different data sets using Azure AI tooling. So let's get started and build this solution out from scratch. But before we do, please can I ask you to subscribe to the channel? It'd really help the channel grow, as I get in a lot of views for this channel, but 90% of those views don't turn into subscribers. So that would really help me. Thank you. Okay, good. So first we begin by setting up Azure OpenAI in the Azure portal, and this gives us access to powerful language models that can understand and generate human-like responses. In the Azure portal, let's go to Azure OpenAI, and then we click Create, and we choose our resource group, and the region we are going to choose in this scenario is East US 2, and we give it a name. And then we can take a look at the pricing tiers available to us as well. So here's the pricing structure, and you will be billed dependent on your requirements per month for this. Okay, click Next, and then we select All Networks. We click Next, and then we Review, and then we Create. And next, we launch Azure AI Foundry to deploy the GPT model. And this platform simplifies model deployment and management, and it lets us scale easily while maintaining performance and security. We drill down into OpenAI and we open the AI Foundry portal. We go to Deployments, and we can add an audio generation model here. And we would normally use the GPT-4.0 real-time preview. However, this is a retired model now, and therefore we will replace this with a mini real-time preview model. We will leave the defaults and deploy in East US. And then next, let's create an AI Foundry search. And with the model in place, we set up Azure AI Search. And this search indexes our private documents. In this case, it's a PDF, and it makes their content easily searchable and retrievable by our chatbot. Let's go to Azure AI Search and click Create. We choose our resource group and we give it a name. Pricing tiers, we choose basic, and we'll be billed for this. And we don't need to scale, so we click Next and then Create. We then need to create an Azure Blob storage account to save our data in, and this will host the PDF files that the user will query through the chatbot. So we go to Azure Storage, we click Create, and then we provide the storage name, and then the region is East US2. We choose Blob Storage, and we just require local redundant storage for this demo, and that should be fine for this solution. And then we keep all the defaults, and then we click Create. And then the storage is created, so we need to add a container, and this acts as a logical space where our documents will reside. And we keep access permissions secure but manageable for our application. Here is our example document that we will upload in the next section. It contains example car part information and part numbers, and the caller can then speak to our chatbot to query the document that we upload. Now we upload the PDF document to the container, and this file, it represents the knowledge base that the chatbot will reference in conversations. To allow secure communication between services, we enable a system assigned identity for the resources, and this lets our application interact with Azure Storage and AI Search without hard coding credentials. Next, we assign RBAC, role-based access control roles, to the system assigned identity, and this ensures only approved services can access or manage the data in our storage account. The permissions that we grant here is storage blob data reader and cognitive services operator. We now deploy a text embedded model to convert uploaded documents into vector representations. And these embeddings enable fast and accurate semantic search within the chatbot's responses. So we go to AI Foundry portal. We deploy a model for text embedding. And we choose the small embedding model for this demo with a deployment type global standard. And then we accept all the defaults, and then we click Create. Okay, great. So now we can upload the PDF documents to be imported and vectorized. So this step transforms the text into numerical data the GPT model can search for. In Azure AI Search, we click on Import and Vectorize Data. And as you can see, we have a good range of data sources to choose from here. So we can choose SQL databases, OneDrive, SharePoint, etc., which is really, really good. So we will choose our blob storage for now that we created and uploaded our PDF to earlier on. We select the storage account, container, and authenticate using system assigned manage identity type, and then we click Next. We then choose the Azure OpenAI service and model deployment, and then select system assigned identity. Pricing for this can be viewed in this document. We don't select Vectorize images or extract text from images in this demo. We click Next and select Enable Semantic Tanker. And choose your indexing schedule if required. We leave ours to none. Click Next, give it a name, and we will leave as Default and Create. So this document, it will take a few minutes to index, and then once done, we can run some search queries on the document to confirm it is returning some information. Under AI Search, we can see the indexes and data sources that we have configured here. So we integrate all components with frontend and backend code. The voice-activated web page, it captures user speech, converts it to text, sends that to GPT for processing, and plays back the answer using speech. We open code from GitHub in VS Code. The links are provided in the description for this. And then we add a .env file with all our values and keys taken from the created solution. For the first OpenAI endpoint value, we copy this from OpenAI and keys and endpoint section. We go to AI Foundry portal and copy the voice model name. Then we copy the key, and I won't paste the key here as this solution is still being used for testing at this time. And for voice choice, we choose Alloy. For the search endpoint, we obtain and copy from AI Search. We also get the search index name, and then we copy the search API key under the managed query keys. Great, all looking good. So now let's run our PowerShell startup script to run our web server in development mode so we can access the voice chat website on our local host. Great, all looking good. So now let's run our PowerShell startup script to run our web server in development mode so we can access the voice chat website on our local host. Excellent, great. So we're ready to go. So let's test this out now in the next section. Finally, we test the live setup so a user speaks into the microphone and the system instantly responds with a helpful answer based on the uploaded data. So this creates a powerful interactive human-like support experience available 24/7. So let's give it a go. Hello, how are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. How about you?
Good, thank you.
You're welcome.
How often do I need to replace my air filter?
It's generally recommended to replace your car's air filter about once a year, or every 12,000 to 15,000 miles, though this interval can be shorter if you often drive in dusty conditions. You're welcome.
How often per year does a fuel filter need to be replaced, and after how many miles?
It's recommended to replace your fuel filter every 2 years, or after every 30,000 kilometers of driving.
I was after an air filter for a BMW G650.
The part number for the air filter for a BMW G650 is BM6507.
I also need a steering rack as well for a Ford Escort 1.6. Do you have the part number?
The part number for the power steering rack for a Ford Escort 1.6 is PR18539.
Thank you ever so much.
You're welcome. If you have any more questions, just let me know.
That's it for now. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a great day.
Okay, bye.
Goodbye. Take care.
Take care.
You too. Goodbye.